Oh god, that's loud. Hey, what's up everyone, and welcome to Quick Play, the series where we take a look at the first 20 or so minutes of a game to see if it entices me to continue playing. Excuse me. And this time, we are taking a look at Sonic Boom, Fire and Ice for the Nintendo 3DS. Now, I have played Sonic Boom Rise of Lyric and Sonic Boom Shattered Crystal, and they're both not great. So, let's hope this one's a little better! I've definitely heard better things about this one, but still, who knows? Let's go. New game.
Radium, my ultimate weapon! Power to fuel my revenge! Revenge against Sonic!
X marks the spot.
Last of the science pole thingies are in. Ready to go online, Tails?
I've been ready since this crazy weather started. I've never seen anything like it, and I've seen lots of crazy things. If this keeps getting worse, it's gonna be game over for the world.
Okay, Amy, batter up! Incredible times a million! That was the most insanely awesome thing I've ever seen! Tails, did you catch that?
I saw the whole thing. I also saw that the weather in your area improved when you closed that fissure. Meet me as soon as you can. I gotta run some tests.
And no, Sonic, you don't need to study for them.
Couple things. One, why did Sonic melt the ice just for Amy to freeze the ice? Two, that we just have the powers now? That's just happening? No explanation or anything? They just accept that? Okay. Switch to fire mode to melt ice. Cool. What's happening? Also, the version of this game that I have came with like a DVD with a couple Sonic Boom episodes on it, I believe, so that's just a thing that I felt like mentioning. Okay, let me check the 3D on this. It's not terrible. But I'm also going to turn it off because I'm tired. Bring hammer parts to Amy's house. They look good in her display case. Press Y to sprint. There's a run button! Sonic, this is like Sonic Lost World. It's got a run button. Why does it have a run button? That's actually really off-putting. I hate that. Oh, God. Was it Lost World? Yeah, Lost World had a run button. Did any other Sonic games have a run button? Press B in the double jump. I know how that works. Homing attack. Ah! Homing attack. So far, this just feels like Shattered Crystal, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, you wanna get the Ragnium to go to Tails' workshop or something. That hint disappeared too quickly. Okay. I mean, it's still better than Rise of Lyric. I can tell you that much right now. Junk parts. Bring them to Styx's Burrow. There are treasures. LRR to toggle between fire and ice. Okay. That's just a thing. That's just a power that they have now, I guess. You know, just like the old days, when Sonic had fire and ice powers. I'm a little confused, I'm not gonna lie. Just a smidgy bit. Whoa! Press A to use the Ender Beam. Of course, I still have the Ender Beam. So, I know that the first game was set, that ice literally just has a fire symbol on it. I feel like I would be able to figure that out, game, you know? Because wasn't the first game set as a prequel to the show, I think, something like that. So where does this game take place in regards to, it, oh, wait, like that. What does this game take place in regards to the last game and the TV show? Like, I am confused. It doesn't really give you any kind of indication, but I guess it's probably not going to. Take a pet up and then do that. Okay, cool. Again, just like the first game. But again, still better than Rise of Lyric. I can say that much. This game is actually playable. Unlike that one. Press A to what? Enter the ice fishing cave. Okay. It's just a challenge room, I guess. What's in here exactly? Are we fishing? Are we just playing a fishing minigame? Got skills, navigate the hazards to collect the trading card at the- Trading card? What? Are they just throwing in every kind of collectible imaginable at this point? Because, I mean, I know the first game had a lot, but a lot of them were, like, required to move on or something like that? I don't know. It's been a long time since I played the first game, since I really saw anything about the first game. So, oh god. I'm dead. Okay. Oh. Okay, well, I guess I'm just back in the challenge room now. Did they give me rings in here? Yes, they did. Okay, good. Yeah, it's been a long time since I've actually seen anything about any Sonic Boom game, because when this one was announced, when they announced, like, hey, we're doing a sequel to Sonic Boom, Shattered Crystal, everyone was like, oh god, why? Because the first one was trash, or the first two games were pretty much trash. But, oh, I did it. Knuckles inside Tails' workshop. Okay. So everyone just has a different collectible. It's the springs for Tails, those for Knuckles, hammers for Amy, and whatever the other thing was for... No, it was Ragnium for Tails, and then the springs for Sticks. Okay. Moving along, I guess that's locked off to us now. Also, Sonic really doesn't feel to be running all that fast. Like, right then, when I was just trying to get started, it's like, yeah, I'm just gonna kinda... Just gonna kinda stroll a little bit. I don't know, I don't wanna just rag on this game over and over again, because... Obviously, I haven't continued playing it. I haven't even, like, finished one level yet, but... Just speaking purely... What the heck? Purely from reviews I've seen, and my experience with the first games... I mean, I don't really know what else I can be expected to think. Also, I screwed that up, whatever that was. Like, I've seen some Call Me Johnny's review on this game. It's been a while, so I don't really remember much about the review, but, I don't remember him having the most positive things to say about it. I remember him saying it was better than the first game. I feel like that's what most people have been saying about this. That looks like the intended way to go, so I'm gonna go this way. And see what we got. Anything at all? Anything of interest? A spring? That's real interesting. Oh, look at that. A spring. That actually is what it was. Goddamn. But... I clearly missed a lot of collectibles around here. Hello. You are another collectible. Yeah, I missed a lot of them. But alright, let's do this. Close the fissure and complete the mission. Cool. Sonic can just fly now, I guess. Oh, I only missed two things. That's not that bad, I suppose. And you have the option to replay the level. There's a time trial for less than 2 minutes? Jesus. Also, Sonic's face looked a little bit off on that model, I'm not gonna lie. Reach the end to collect a trading card. Cool. Amy is now unlocked for play. Okay. And how- wait, did I just- Oh, what the I thought I had to press A to, like, get the Amy thing off the screen. It just sent me back into Glacier Forest. That's not what I wanted to do at all. God damn it, can I just leave? Does it let me just leave? Oh, I can be Amy now. Cool. Hold on, down on the D-pad, what does that do? That just shows me my collectibles that I have? And... What about- oh. Oh, it's... And now I have a map? Wait, was that there the whole time? No, I don't care, Tails, I don't care. I just want to look at the map. Because I want to see if there's anything that I missed. Because- oh, okay, she's got a little hammer move, that's interesting. Tails, I don't care. Oh god. And I'm dead. Alright, can we- Could we leave this level? I don't think we need to do it again. Let's just go. Get out of this level. Because I didn't mean to accidentally go to it. Yeah. I don't know the plot yet. I mean, I guess we're going around closing fissures, which I'm gonna guess Eggman caused. Oh. I pressed the D-pad. That was a bad idea, apparently. Down we go, Sonic. There we go. Frozen Hollow. Let's do this.
Your turn, Amy.
Your turn, Amy? What? I get to play as Amy now? I mean, I played as Amy before. But I can play as Amy again. Cool. Maybe she'll have some actual, like, level-specific stuff just for her. I can't wait to unlock all the characters, because that'd be great, but I'm probably not gonna get that far. I think I just moved the mic, too. My headphones are connected to my mic, and I think I just tugged on them and moved the mic, so I'm sorry if you heard that. Okay, oh, ooh! Ooh, background, stage. Let me put the 3D on. Because we got that background in the back there. Wait, what did that say, Tails? Use a touchscreen to switch between characters. Yep. Use Amy's hammer to move pillars. Not a huge fan of how it, like, says on it, what ability you're supposed to use. It's the same for the fire and ice doors as well, like, I feel like that's not necessary. I feel like I could figure that much out, but... I got a hammer right there. I feel like I could figure that much out, by myself, like, hey, that's the thing for Amy. But I guess not. I'll take you out, oh, is that a collectible? That is a collectible. Oh, it's one of you. Dang it, I feel like I should have gone the other way. Let me up. Let me up. Go. Hit the button. I guess... No, she doesn't have a thing like Sonic. Never mind. No, come on. There we go. We got some Ragnium, I guess. Cool. Wait, how quickly can you switch characters? It looks like you might have to be on the ground to do it. But hey, we got a thing. Got a spring right there. Yep, gotta be Amy. Oh no, you can do it in the air. Alright, so it's not too incredibly fast, but it's decent. And I want to go back because there was definitely something over to the left there that I missed. Because I saw those weird little dragon coin things appear. And I was like, I gotta go get him. Gotta go get him right now. What's over here? Are you a super secret? I'm gonna be Sonic real quick. Well, I feel like they probably just want me to be Amy. Because, everything has been Amy in this level so far, and now we're in the background. And we're going left. Yep, Amy again. Maybe this isn't a secret area, and it's just another pathway I could have taken? Oh, it's to a challenge room. Okay. Let's do it. Let's go in the challenge room. See, now that I have two characters, and I'm moving around, I'm switching between them, using different kinds of abilities, I'm enjoying it a little more than that first level. But it still just feels like more of the same from the first game, you know? I don't know if that's just me, but it just feels like they took Shattered Crystal and made another Shattered Crystal. Oh, that... I see. I gotta do that. And then I gotta switch between them as I jump? No, I don't even have to do that. I can just go through it. Okay. Would have been kind of cool if I had to switch between them as I jumped, but oh god! Alright then. Break you. Nope, that spikes. Okay, fine. We'll just go down there. I'm over here thinking there might be some cool special secrets down there, but nope. Just do what it wants you to do. Is there anything up? No, here I am looking for secrets again that probably don't exist. Okay, made it through there, and got the trading card! I guess that's the point of the challenge rooms, like, they're just for trading cards. I imagine that's probably the case. Probably the case. But who knows? Oh, you guys probably know. Well, someone out there knows. Alright, where does this take us then? Are we back in the foreground now? I feel like we're coming more towards the foreground. Oh, now we're in the foreground. I don't know where we are. Oh, we're right back here. So yeah, that was a super secret guy, I guess. Oh no, this is the dragon coins again? What? We get to do it again for another piece of Ragnium? Whoops. I guess. Let's switch to Sonic so we can get up there a little faster. Yeah, that's the exact same area again, we just got another piece of Ragnium. Okay. Tap the map icon to view the adventure map. Yeah, you should just have that on by default, really. Well, I guess because they want you to... If you want to switch characters, you've got to have it off. But... So we can go down. Yeah, look at that, okay. Now is there a different button to switch... Oh, I can just use the D-pad to switch characters. Okay. As opposed to touching the touchscreen. Cool, I'm out. I see a green check mark coming up. What is that for? Is it just to have a green check mark? Oh, it's a checkpoint. Okay. Quite literally. Oh. Amy, break that. Sonic, go fast. There we go. I don't like how they've got so many different options on the touchscreen, and it's so awkward to switch between them. Especially, like, Momentum, I don't want to keep going, I want to stop. Oh, well, now I can't go back. Or can I? Does this take me back? Because I definitely missed something. Where the heck am I going? I don't know where I'm going. Okay, now I'm here. Now I'm going down. Is that the thing that I missed before? Okay, well, I guess we're just not getting what we missed before. Cool. We're just moving on. I got picked up by a turtle. I thought that might have done some damage to me, but no. Alright. What's that little robot guy back off to the left on the map right there? I guess that's probably what that secret was, but I don't get to find out because the game locked me out of it. Just a little bit. We're back in the background. Let's go left. Again, I can't tell, like, what's the intended path and what's a secret. There's no way to really tell. Which is a little odd, I will admit, but, sure, whatever. Also, don't know how we would have gotten past that enemy. Maybe with the hammer. Well, probably exactly like that, but... Alright, another robot. So it's literally just telling us about the robots that are coming up, I guess, on the map. Yeah, it just tells you the locations of all of the enemies, which seems very counterintuitive that they would do that. Oh, another... No, I need that! Another freaking dragon coin thing. Also, what are the dragon coins? Oh, nope. Nope, you know what? We're gonna go back. We're gonna go back. Can we do that again? Is it not coming back? It came back for us before. Alright, I guess that doesn't work either. Cool. Good job, video game. I'm dead. Where's that gonna put us back? I don't remember where this checkpoint is. Oh! Okay, well, we're here now. Where was this at? This is new. God damn. Freaking Amy. Cooperate, please. Alright, I think we're probably gonna end this level. And then we'll be, like, pretty close to the end of the quick play, because almost been 20 minutes. And I'll be honest, I don't want to play more of this game than I have to. I know you're probably like, oh, you're just being the guy because Sonic Boom. Really, my dude? You don't want to do that just because it's Sonic Boom and because of its reputation. No, I just don't. I'm not really having a fun time with this. To be honest with you, it just feels like more of the same from Shattered Crystal, and I played a decent amount of Shattered Crystal after I did, I think it was the Let's Demo? I don't own Shattered Crystal, but I know that I've played it somewhere. I don't quite remember where, but I've definitely played it. And I didn't have fun with it. Well, do I own it? No, I don't own Sonic Boom Shattered Crystal. I have this one, but I don't have the first one. We got everything in that one. Okay, cool. Except the time trial, of course. We got all the collectibles. Oh, I pressed A. You know, the button you would think is, you know, move on, but no, A is go again, for some reason. For some goddang reason. Additional Ragnium can be collected via Street Pass. Okay. What is in here? Because it's all shiny. Kodiak Frontier? Okay. And what about this? This is just telling us about the levels? Oh. What's happening? Oh, it just teleports you to that level. Okay. What was this again? And that just teleports us to wherever that is. Okay. We got two options. We have, what, Cliffside Blizzard, I think that said. Or Darkened Depths. And there's tails, and there's just one thing? Oh, God. Oh, it's one of those submarine levels like in Shattered Crystal. Sea Fox. Collect the trading card before time runs out. Circle pad to move, X to shoot. Okay. Let me turn the 3D on again. Yeah, it's basically non-existent in this area. Oh, God. Alright, tap the screen. Oh, so I think that was in the first game as well. With the, oh, those are like mines? I keep thinking those are just things. There we go, that's... I'm dead. What the heck is happening? Okay. Then I'm not going to the left this time. I'm gonna go down this way. What is the point in having the radar if I can just continually tap the screen to make stuff appear? Why doesn't the map just stay there? I guess if I touch walls as well, that's what's doing a little bit of damage to me. Which, you know, it didn't specify, but that's a thing, I guess. I guess I'm just supposed to know that. That's a dog poppy the Are we good? We're still good, I think. Beep, 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 beep. Give me my freaking trading card. All that for a trading card. I got... No, I didn't get the record. Did I get the record? I think I did. I don't know which is my time and which is the goal time. But we did it. Oh, there's another one? No, I pressed A again. Oh my god, why is A not continue? Why is A play the level again? Okay. You know what, maybe it's because it's 9:40 p.m. and I didn't sleep much last night. Or maybe it's because the game is bad, but that wasn't great. I didn't have a great time with that. That's... Both Let's Demo and Quick Play this week have been incredibly underwhelming. I don't know why I lined these two games up together for me. But, I think that's gonna go ahead and do it for this Quick Play of Sonic Boom! Fire and Ice. You can usually tell, just before watching a Quick Play episode, you can usually tell if I enjoyed it by the length of it. If it's close to 20 minutes, I was probably making a damn good effort to just do 20 minutes. Anyway, that's gonna go ahead and do it. I'm probably not gonna be continuing to play this game, at least not for the foreseeable future. I intend on covering some of the Sonic Boom games over on Booster Pack at some point, or maybe I'll get Zach to do them, I don't know. But we shall see, so. That's gonna do it, so thank you all for watching. If you guys enjoyed, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comments section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.